Welcome back. So last week, a program set to boost the technical and managerial capacity of smallholder farmers was launched. And the program is dubbed Entrepreneurship for Commercial Seed Incubation, acronymed ECoSIB. We're discussing ECoSIB this morning. My guests are Mr. Dan Akwey, Executive Director, Agri Impact, who are running ECoSIB. And then there's also next to him, Mr. Foster Boateng, Country Director, AGRA SSTP Ghana. I gather they're funding ECoSIB. We'll talk about that. Well, gentlemen, you're welcome to New Day. Here at TV3. Is this your first time here on New Day?
Well, my first time.
It's your first time too. Mm-hmm. You're welcome. I can tell from the discussion we're going to have that we'll have to be seeing more of you. Yes. There are several questions you have to answer.
Absolutely.
So, Africa imports some $50 billion worth of food annually. Obviously, it doesn't take a genius to figure out that this provides enormous opportunities for joint business growth and development, which actually would have residual benefits because we're looking at job creation, you know, in events would reduce the rate of unemployment on the continent. In your estimation, what are the hindrances? What are the encumbrances? Why can't we embrace such opportunities?
Let me pick this one. We are importing food because, first of all, Africa is the least when it comes to productivity in the world.
It's the least productive continent.
If you take maize, for example, some countries may be getting about 15 metric tons, 12 metric tons per hectare, and Ghana is getting about 1.7, 1.9 metric tons per hectare. So if you have 10 people working on 10 hectares, what they are getting might be equivalent to in another country where one person is getting on a hectare. So our productivity is very low. The second thing is that agriculture is not well coordinated and it is not well resourced. In most countries, you have a lot of investment from public sector going into agriculture. In our case, we don't have it that much. And the role of the private sector in agriculture in Africa is also reduced because there are more than challenges that the private sector can handle. If you are an agribusiness entrepreneur and you want to invest in agriculture in Ghana, for example, you might be the road contractor, you will connect your electricity, there is no irrigation, you have to do it yourself, the marketing systems are not well organized. So in the end, it costs so much to do business in agri, and our cost of borrowing is also very high. Mm-hmm. And when you put all this together with poor infrastructure support, then we become less competitive. So it becomes cheaper and easier for people to import food than even producing it in our own countries.
I don't suppose any farmer worth his salt, you know, will just throw seeds around and expect a magic yield, you know, a bumper harvest. I understand from his submission that there are intricate steps to be followed. What in your view are Ghanaian farmers not doing right?
Well, let me backtrack.
So yes, let me please, Ghanaian
farmers. I think farmers have to do what they got to do. It's what is available, it's what they do. Now, when Dan was talking, he outlined some problems that are confronting the agricultural sector. I think AGRA, our position has been we need to transform African agriculture. And it's in the hands of smallholder farmers. These farmers don't have access to improved technology like their counterparts in other developed countries. So first of all, what AGRA is doing is how can we improve the input that the farmer uses as his first point of production, that seed. That's the point that you raise. So we're looking at seeds that will give them better returns on their investments. Mm. So farmers over the years have been planting their own safe seed. And over time, the genetic quality is being lost.
And safe seed is the seed we get from the
farmers
harvest.
From their own harvest, okay. And they go back and plant.
Okay.
And definitely, as they continue to do that, the yield continue to dwindle.
Why? It's a natural seed. I mean,
yeah, because
it should reproduce.
You know, it has a recessive gene as you continue to produce. As you said, as you wash your own clothes, it continue to
wear and tear, subject to
wear and tear. You have to replace.
Okay.
So farmers are not replacing those seeds. So what AGRA SSTP is doing is, how can we make improved seeds accessible to farmers? How can we sensitize farmers to know that planting improved seeds will give you much returns in terms of your yield. So that is the work that we are doing now. And again, farmers getting access to the seed, seed alone will not give them the required returns. Mm. They need to do improved soil fertility management. That's providing fertilizer to some of the soil, because some of the soil have been, they've been farming on that land for a long time. It's been degraded. All the soil fertility is gone.
Okay.
So they need to put in some
okay, fertilizer. But back to superior quality of seeds. What would give a seed its superiority? What would make the seed superior over and over another?
Okay. The seeds we are talking about, yeah, we call them certified seed.
Certified seeds.
And when you look at
certified
this,
by
certified,
whom?
Certified by the seed inspection unit. Because they have to go, they have to, of the Ministry of Food and Agriculture.
Okay,
they need to go through certain protocols to be for it to be qualified as seed.
Mm.
Starting point is they need a breeder seed. So the National Agricultural Research Institutes are producing the breeder seed.
Mm.
Crop Research Institute and Savannah Agricultural Research Institute in Tamale. They produce the breeder seed and they give the breeder seed to another organization to produce foundation seed. And from foundation seed, yes, then they give it to private seed companies to multiply to certified seed. So there are certain protocols that you need to go through that qualifies it to be a superior seed. And that is what the farmers must have access to.
So do these superior seeds stay resilient forever?
No. Over time, the farmers plant and you need to replace them. You need to replace your seed.
Okay.
We have two types.
Okay, these fall in the range of GMOs?
No, it's not GMO. It's not GMO. I mean, that is totally...
Okay.
We have local varieties that have been developed by our local scientists.
Mm, okay.
That can even quadruple yields. We don't need to even to think about GMOs. Even our local varieties that have been improved and developed by our own scientists from our own soils can even give us good returns.
So okay. how is ECoSIB rising to these challenges?
Well, in our case, we realize that these small-scale seed producers, they need to be strengthened to be able to handle seed as a business.
Okay. Also, ECoSIB is not directly with smallholder farmers or small-scale farmers. There's a business which targets the farmers.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Mm.
And like you said, the smallholder farmers would definitely be the ultimate beneficiaries of the intervention of AGRA SSTP program. But you need the private sector. The private sector people produce the certified seeds, and the certified seeds are distributed or sold to the farmers. So if you don't have enough certified seeds, farmers will not have enough seeds to also plant. And as we speak now, most of the crops that we have in the country, we don't have enough certified seeds.
Mm.
If you look at maize, I think we are doing just about 10% or less of what is required.
Even and though it's a staple.
Yes, yes. Okay. And even if you look at it from 2011 to 2015, the quantity or the amount of certified seeds that we produce has dropped from 2,600 metric tons to 2,100 metric tons. If you take rice, we have also come down to about 5% of what is required. So already there's a huge gap between what is required and what we have. And that gap is where we want to fill in. And you are filling in by building the managerial and the technical capacities of the seed companies so that they will be able to produce more, become profitable and competitive. Because the law also allows seed importation. So if we don't have our local institution strengthened, then at a point in time we'll be lost out of competition.
What is the range of seeds, or does it cut across all crops?
No, well, under our program we are focusing and targeting only the staples. We're talking about maize, mm-hmm. we're talking about cowpea,
mm-hmm.
soybean, yam, cassava, and then also rice. So these are the staples that we are looking at.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, obviously, the objective of ECoSIB is extensive and comprehensive.
Yeah.
It would demand some synergy with key stakeholders. Yes. I can readily think of the Crop Research Institute.
Exactly.
Are you working in partnership with them?
Exactly.
Yes.
Actually, ECoSIB is not working in isolation.
Mm.
And I think most of the varieties that have been developed through AGRA program.
Yes.
That's the one that they are taking up to scale.
Yes.
That is what they are really sensitizing the seed companies to, yes, to multiply.
Yes.
And then also they are working with, I think, University of Science, yeah, and Technology, because of the training aspect of the program.
Yes.
And they have a number of, I think, institutions, yeah, that were MOFA, Minister of Food and Agriculture, because you cannot talk about agriculture in Ghana and without talking about MOFA. So some of these protocol regimes, we need to work with MOFA,
yeah,
to be able to clear them.
And let me also add that we are working with FARA, the Forum for Agricultural Research in Africa, which is a continental organization, mm, under AU, promoting agricultural research.
I just wanted to ask if this had been implemented elsewhere in Africa so we can do a progress follow-up.
The seed incubation is the first of its kind in Africa.
Mm.
You can, there are a lot of seed interventions in Africa, but for seed incubation,
yes,
this is the first type in
I recall when I was doing my master's in international affairs, there was a course we had to take in agriculture, and we studied about tissue culture. Mm. Is this anywhere related?
Those ones, let's leave it to the breeders.
Ah, okay, that's the breeders.
Yeah,
okay,
the breeders,
because we have the seed,
yeah,
and then the breeders.
Yeah, we have three stages of,
uh-huh,
the seed. The breeder seed,
okay,
the foundation seed, and certified seed.
Yeah.
We are focusing on the certified seed,
yeah,
because we need to strengthen the capacity of the private sector.
My memory is not that bad.
That.
Yeah. 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 And to strengthen the certified seed sector, you need to also work backwards with the foundation seed,
yeah,
and the breeder seed,
mm,
because that is what you use,
mm,
to produce your certified, mm, seed. So that's why we are working with the Crop Research Institute,
yeah,
and then KNUST.
Yeah.
The, we are using incubation also because we're working with the African Agribusiness Incubator Network,
mm,
which is also trying to promote the incubation as a model, yeah, to transfer technology to a lot of SMEs.
Okay, let's look at the chain of distribution and, you know, how widely these seeds would penetrate the hinterlands. I just took a story when I was doing the business news about farmers in Daboya, in, you know, the Gonja districts of the northern region,
yeah,
who continually till the land and yet die in abject poverty. How accessible are these seeds to them?
Okay, under the AGRA SSTP program, we have an extensive program covering almost the whole country. And what we are doing is we are working through MOFA with extension officers. We are also working through the agro dealer hub system, where agro dealers are private sector people, because we form alliance with the private sector so that they can take some of these seeds and set up satellite distribution centers. The reason why sometimes the farmers don't use the improved seeds is, one, they haven't heard about it, they don't know it,
mm,
they can't get access to it,
yeah,
they have to travel long distances to get it,
yeah,
forget it, they won't go.
Yeah.
So working with these private sector people,
yeah,
they will take it and do the distribution network.
Yeah.
So we are really sensitizing and strengthening them through another grant system that we have,
yeah,
with a company called Agri Services, AgriMall, AGSMall. AGSMall is working with agro dealers. And what they are doing with agro dealers is, in each region, this hub agro dealers must set up satellite centers within their districts and within their villages.
Oh.
You believe you me? I don't think when you live in a village, you have to come to the city to buy Coca-Cola.
Well,
you get Coca-Cola in every little corner.
I'd ask my father. He lived in the village.
You see, I lived in the village. So you see, you don't need to even travel to the city to buy Coca-Cola. Every little corner, you get a Coca-Cola. So how can we take,
yeah,
seed distribution to, yeah, that level, where farmers don't need to walk distances? Before AGRA came, farmers have to travel 19 kilometers in the northern part of Ghana to really access seed or inputs. But now, 3 kilometers, we have even reduced to 3-4 kilometers. We wish it could come to even 0.5 kilometers.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, so this is a whole chain. I mean,
yes,
that starts,
yeah,
with you, and,
yes,
then the business company, the,
exactly,
seed company,
exactly,
and then to the smallholder, yeah, farmers.
Exactly.
But would you know what monitoring evaluation measures have been put in place? You see, because at a point, we need to know if some progress is being made at all.
Well, I think monitoring is at all levels. It's not even just only at the business level. Even the farmers, at the farmers level, there's a monitoring going on, even at the breeders level, even at the foundation seed level, even at the certified seed level. So if you look at AGRA, our program, I mean, we collaborate with a number of institutions,
mm-hmm,
and then we try to track the performance down the value chain.
Mm-hmm.
So it's multidisciplinary.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay, and this is where you come in as funders
for ECoSIB.
Okay.
Yeah. And ECoSIB is implemented by a lead private sector firm called AGRA. And what ECoSIB is doing now, we're looking at the management capacity of the seed incubator, the seed enterprises. Marketing is a big issue. And as Foster mentioned, and you rightly said, the farmers are not getting seeds. And you have some of the seed companies that have also produced seeds, and they say, we don't have market. So how come you produce, you are not getting market, somebody wants it, he cannot find.
Yes.
Then there's some information gap. So how do we bridge that gap?
Yes.
It's market information system that needs to be improved. The second thing is that we don't see too much improvement in the performance of the seed companies.
Mm.
And it is because the business practices are not there. I mean, the financial systems, record keeping is not there, marketing plan is not there. And when you ask them, they've been doing it over years, but the growth rate is so small. And that is why ECoSIB also comes in, and that is why AGRA decided to let a private sector lead this project so that we can transfer not only technical knowledge, but business management practices to the SMEs. And why are we using incubation? We have also realized that over the years there have been a lot of interventions to most small-scale farmers and enterprises. And majority of the tools or means that we have used is through workshop. So you take the farmers or let's say the seed companies to a workshop and you present, you make excellent presentations and everybody will nod their head and they all understand. It's a good work done. But when they go back, the competence and confidence to even start implementing what they heard, it's not that they did not understand, they understood it, they know the benefit all right, but the confidence to start implementing change is a big issue. And that is why Agri Impact and its partners decided to use the incubation model, which brings in more of hand-holding. So if you go for workshop and you are trained, we need to get some experts who come back to your farm, come back to your company, and help you put the systems up, help you manage the system, help you interpret results that you are getting. And through that, then the private sector will begin to grow. And once they begin to grow, then you can have more production of the certified seeds and then access to.
So you've already started a series of workshops.
Yes.
How do we even access you? How do we even find you? How can you be contacted?
Sell yourself.
Yes.
Yes, we our office is at East Legon, and then we have our telephone numbers as well.
Okay.
0244-360-763. And then you can also go to Agri Impact website. We have our Facebook page. If you type in ECoSIB, it will take you to our Facebook page.
Thank you very much. Mr. Dan Akwe is Executive Director, Agri Impact, who are running the ECoSIB program, Entrepreneurship for Commercial Seed Incubation as well. There's Mr. Foster Boateng, Country Director, Coordinator, AGRA SSTP. What's AGRA SSTP?
AGRA is Alliance for Grain Revolution in Africa.
Okay.
And then SSTP is Scaling Seed and Technology Partnership.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So, Country Coordinator for that.
It's a mouthful, that's why I make SSTP.
It is a mouthful. Yeah. All right, well, you're watching New Day, and we'll be back after this. Actually, Nana Kojo Afre is standing by for some sports news.